Hey, Grandpa. I want to show you something.
Oh, okay.
Out here. Being my grandpa's last season, I want us to get as much gold as possible so that, you know, he can head out of here and feeling like we had a win.
What do you got?
I got these drill maps, Keener's drill maps.
Yeah.
From last year.
Yeah.
Now that we're running the lost cut, it's looking like Keener's drill maps are actually more accurate than we thought.
25 years ago, geologist Jeff Keener did extensive research on the land at Mammoth Valley Mine, creating maps and soil analysis reports.
This is my map, what, 25 years ago, just about. So this map shows the claim configuration at the time, and then all the drill holes that I drilled out here.
His research was critical in leading the Hoffmans to the lost cut.
You guys might be in for a real treat here. I hope you are.
So basically, what I'm trying to do is get ahead of the game a little bit.
Yeah.
And so when we run out of pay in the lost cut, we kind of know where we want to go. By the time they have all the pay out of the lost cut, I want to have our second option kind of ready to go. Time is of the essence, and I'm going to do a little bit of mapping and run point out in front of everybody and see if we can find another area that has crazy gold.
So now that we're getting some gold, I can kind of break away. Mm-hmm. And then maybe you even go with me. We go kind of poke around and see.
Yeah, I'd love to do that.
What else we can do.
I'd love to go prospecting with you, yeah.
We just got to figure out, you know, where can we go in the time that we have.
Yeah, so, and time is running out. There is ground here that goes up to 77 ounces a 100. That's unheard of. I already know that Hunter will find it this season, and I'm not going to miss the opportunity to go with him. You know, I'm on my way out. Todd doesn't realize it, but he's getting closer to that. Hunter is the future.
It's getting colder. Dude, this is treacherous.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where do you think that trench is?
This is where we're at?
Yeah.
So I think it's just a little bit farther that way, along the edge.
Let's try to get there.
Okay, we're close. We're trying to put the pieces together and figure out off a map from 25 years ago where exactly they were digging. So treasure maps aren't always the easiest to read. Might need to go this way a little bit.
Yeah, I'll come over that way after I get through here.
It's just hard to pinpoint if you're in the right spot or not, and it's just so overgrown.
But I think the trench is right here. Hunter?
Yeah.
Right here is where he was digging. It's definitely been digging.
You think this is the hole?
This is the trench.
Where do you think we should pull from? You think right here?
I would go, down at the bottom, not up at the top.
Yeah.
Just throw all the big rocks out. Yeah.
It's hard to tell for sure if we're in the right spot or not. Right now, it's really frustrating to be out here with buckets and shovels. Mining's evolved a lot over the last 25 years, and so there's a lot of tools that we could use.
Okay, how's prospecting going out there?
It's going okay, but it just takes forever. I think that we should invest a little bit more into, you know, finding new ground.
Yeah.
I have a couple ideas I want to try. Okay. One of them is a LIDAR, like ground penetrating drone that uses radar. And apparently that can tell the depth of bedrock, if ground's virgin or not, everything else, and kind of give us a picture that way. And then just getting around takes forever. So I think it'd be a good idea to bring in a Sherp, you know, those off-road amphibious vehicles, because then we can cruise around out here and not get stuck.
You actually think there's one around?
Yeah, I got a lead on one that we could get up here and at least have it for the rest of the summer. It's gonna cost a little bit of money, but as of right now, it's a lot of pressure to figure out how we're gonna even run dirt the rest of the season.
I know.
Cut's got, two, 3 weeks?
There is pressure on you. Use technology, use whatever you can. Try to keep it under 50 grand. But if you, hopefully you can find us some pay dirt. Otherwise, we're gonna be going home. We're not gonna hit our goal.
Okay.
You know, Hunter is feeling the pressure. He's trying to find some pay dirt. It's not an easy thing to do, but if he wants to bring in some new technology, he wants to bring in some new ways to get around, hey, more power to them. Any money that I spend towards that is investing into the future of this mine.
I like it. Okay. Let me know what you need from me.
Okay, I will.
All right, bud, good job.
This is crazy.
This is a Sherp.
There it is. I've never really seen one in person.
Yeah, you have a chance to try it.
It's getting colder, the wind's blowing, and we're running out of time to find new ground. So my dad, he gave me the green light to make some moves.
Hunter's all-new terrain vehicle, the Sherp, is an ATV, a snowmobile, a boat, and hovercraft all in one.
So it's inflated the tires themselves.
The exhaust inflates the tires?
Yeah, yeah.
Whoa. Okay, let's do it.
All right.
I'm excited to get the Sherp out here, the LiDAR drone, and then I have the tools, you know, that I need to go out and pinpoint, you know, where the next pay should be coming from.
Okay. Let's go.
Here we go.
We're just cruising in the tundra.
It's like relaxing.
Yeah.
Go all the way
out
in there.
Oh, yeah. Find the new gold places.
Ew, that's what I'm talking about. This is sweet. This is exactly what I needed. I love it. We did it.
Love it. You done well. You done well.
There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I gotta grab some gold.
Back at North Fork, work continues to get Jack's plant operational. Using a rubber diverter, the team has blocked off one side of the sluice, creating a more efficient water flow.
Okay, put a washer on it so it supports it better. All right.
There, perfect.
I don't know where it would leak.
In theory, it's ready to go. In actuality, I don't know. I've never ran material on it at all. I just want to know if it works. If it works, it's a great test plant.
What the heck? Dude, I hope you rented that and didn't buy it. Dude, no way. Look at this thing.
Dude, this
isn't this thing crazy? It's a lot better than the Nodwell. It's quicker, it's faster, you can go through the water, it doesn't tear anything up.
It's a manual, a little stick shift.
We'll go find us some gold.
Okay, I wanna try. As always, the time is ticking. You know, I'm just trying to work a little bit smarter instead of harder. And so hopefully in a couple weeks, I have our next place to pull pay out of and hopefully save this season.
Four down.
God, it feels more than the last one. 20.
40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 88, 90, 90, 100. 104, 109, 110, 114. 116, 118, 119, 122.7.
No way.
All right, big baller week.
Whew, that's okay. Our second biggest cleanup ever.
It's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
It's
pretty
good.
It's really good. Yeah.
Woo. Yeah. That cut, man, this thing is money.
Yeah,
hard work.
Let's keep grinding.
Works, man.
Way to go, guys. Way to go.
It's still early in the season, but the Hoffmans have managed to get 315.4 ounces of their 3,033 ounce goal. This week's haul is worth well over $200,000, but they still have 2,718 more ounces to go.
Whatever you're doing, Andy, keep doing it, man. Triple digits.
We keep bringing dirt. We should just keep doing this every clean out.
Yeah. At some point, we're going to need to find some more pay. Right now, we got all our eggs in one basket, and that's kind of scary.
Yeah, I'm kind of looking for a needle in the haystack, to be honest. Got to find something that's not frozen that we can actually get to that's got good gold. So I'll just keep poking around, and we'll see what we can find.